Good morning, children. Hope you all are doing good. So today we will start new chapter, that is chapter number 15, Hygiene, a Key to Healthy Life. Now, as one old Arabian proverb says, he who has health has hope, and he who has hope has everything. This means that good health is important for us. Children, if a person can maintain a good health, then he will not only live longer, but can also work harder, can achieve more success, and become an asset to the society. So it is advisable to eat nutritious food and maintain cleanliness to stay away from diseases. Now, what are diseases and what are the types of diseases? I will explain you in the next chapter. Now, children, as the word health reminds us of health of being well. So according to Hippocrates, who is the father of medicine, and our ancient Indian Ayurveda system, health is a state of body and mind, and a perfect balance between various body fluids like blood is required to maintain a healthy state. So this definition of health, which is given by our Ayurveda system and Hippocrates, who is the father of medicine, was revised by the WHO, World Health Organization, and according to them, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. So based on his WHO researches and all, the constitution of WHO came into force on 7th April 1948, which is celebrated every year as World Health Day. Now, personal hygiene can be maintained if our surroundings are clean. So what are hygiene? What is hygiene? So it is defined as the science and practice of maintaining good health. The word hygiene is derived from a Greek word hygia, meaning goddess of health. Now, here I am showing you few factors which affect the maintenance of our good health. First one is balanced diet. As you all know that balanced diet is very important, otherwise we will suffer from deficiency diseases. Next is personal hygiene, community hygiene, adequate exercise and rest, protection from communicable diseases. Any disturbance or imbalance of any of these factors may result to disease. Now, all the public places, what is social hygiene or sanitation? So as we know that all the public places should be clean, like school, colleges, hospitals, stations, cinema halls should always be neat and clean. Even government and our local organizations or our civic bodies like municipalities and all, they should take initiative to create awareness and spread education about diseases and their causative agents, symptoms and their prevention measures. They should also maintain proper cleanliness by disposing of the garbage from colonies, from societies. Other health awareness program they should conduct vaccination program also, and they are doing the same. Few programs they are still conducting. Now, all the public drains and garbage must be covered from some disinfectant such as bleaching powder, lime, etc. must be frequently sprinkled. Now, the civic bodies must ensure the supply of germ-free drinking water, and they should plant a efficient sewage disposal system. Now, what are vectors? So vector is any agent that act as an intermediate carrier of the pathogen. You can see in the picture that I am showing you here. Now, insects are the carrier of disease causing germs and are called vectors. So these insects, picture you can see, mosquitoes, हाउस फ्लाइज, कॉकरोचेस, इवन रैट्स, दे आर कंसिडर्ड एज अ वैक्टर्स एंड दे आर द वर्स्ट पब्लिक एनिमीज. हाउ? सो एज यू कैन सी इन दिस इमेज, आई एम शोइंग यू वैक्टर्स. इन द फर्स्ट कॉलम यू कैन सी द डिसीज, दे आर पॉजिटिव एजेंट, सम वैक्टर्स, flies and mosquitoes and their infection, how they infect the person. So by biting, by contamination of food, when we eat contaminated food, then we can get suffered from such diseases like malaria, dengue fever, African sleeping sickness, cholera, dysentery, etc., encephalitis, etc. So some are caused by plasmodium, some are virus, and some are protozoa, some are vibrio cholera and all. Now, how these house flies spread the disease? So house flies are generally found in untidy and dirty places. They usually sit on garbages, fecal matter, and germ from this filled stick on their legs or their lower body. And when they sit on the food that we eat, they transmit disease carrying germs. Flies are vectors. Remember always, flies are vectors of bacteria, viruses, protozoa, worms, etc. So first point, how they spread the disease is by their feet and body hairs. So they have three pairs of legs with claws and spines which help them to cling to object. So their hairy body also pick up pathogen along with the dirt from dirty places, and when they sit on food, they leave the pathogen behind on it. Second point is pouring out saliva. So the mouth of these flies, they suck liquid fluid from exposed eatables and excreta. These pathogen is sticking on their mouth part and are transferred to the food just by a single touch. Okay, sometimes flies pour the swallowed food back. Whatever they are eating, they are swallowed. Basically, they are doing vomit. So that is called regurgitation. Okay, that vomit one. So when they sit on exposed food, they can also transmit germs easily. Third one is excreta. So it deposits its excreta while it feeds and just contaminate the food. Now direct also they can transmit the germs to a healthy person. So for example, in the case of trichoderma, it is a eye disease. So when they sit on the, when this fly sit on the infected patient eye, so they can catch these germs and infect to the healthy person. How can we eliminate it? So we can easily eliminate it by stopping their breeding places. So wherever they are breeding, we have to covered by a layer of the soil, or we have to cover that place so that they will not breed. Now spraying, we should avoid the breeding. We should keep our houses clean. We can spray the insecticides also, like DDT. Full form of DDT is dichlorodiphenyl trichloroethane. So we can use DDT, we can spray DDT to kill the house flies. And avoidance means we should not allow to sit that place where house flies are there. We should avoid that sitting in that places, especially in the newborn baby cases. We should use the mosquito nets and umbrellas so that house flies house flies will not sit on their bodies and spread germs. Next one is mosquitoes. So how mosquitoes? So there are three mosquitoes, and first one is female anopheles mosquito, which is spread malaria in man also, monkeys also, and bird also. So the malaria germ is a protozoa, plasmodium. All right. So next variety of mosquito is Culex mosquito. It is spread elephantiasis and filariasis disease. So in this case, elephantiasis, a person leg swollen like a elephant leg. That's why the name is elephantiasis. It is caused by the nematode worm called Vucheraria. Now third type of mosquito is Aedes mosquito, which is spread yellow fever and dengue, and both caused by the respective viruses. So it is a virus diseases. Now, how they just in spread? So the germs of these diseases are spread when the mosquito bite to suck blood. Okay, when it suck blood, with this blood, the mosquito receive germs of a particular diseases which grow and multiply within their body. When such infected mosquito bite a healthy person, these germs are introduced into his body through the saliva. So it can infect the healthy person. Now, how we can control it? The control measures are the same by spraying insecticides and all DDT, by eliminate the breeding process, covering upon the ponds and puddles and all by a layer of the soil or just cleaning it. We can spray kerosene oil or some other greasy oil into the stagnant water so that it will kill the mosquito larva and pupa. Biological control is also given, as you can see the picture also, and fourth point also, that certain fishes are there, name is Gambusia. So Gambusia is this fish which prefer to eat mosquito larva. So if you will just drop the fishes in that mosquito larva breeding pond, so it will kill these fishes will clean the water. Now cockroaches. So cockroaches is also can easily found in the hidden areas of the manholes of sewers, cupboards, wardrobes and all in our kitchen area and all, because they are omnivorous and eat all types of food. On omnivorous, you know, they can eat animal products also and plant products also. So they believe to spread the cholera disease, diarrhea disease, dysentery disease and typhoid. How to control it? We can can go for cockroach spray. We can use the DDT, BHC. BHC is benzene hexachloride insecticide, malathion. Okay, and we should keep our house clean. We should do proper mobbing and all. We should do dusting and all properly. Cockroach pest control, we can go. We can opt. Now rats. Rats are the four. This one is the serious domestic pest, which besides eating grains, as we all know, it can cause diseases also like plague, typhus fever, etc. Even the germs of plague infect rat fleas, which are ectoparasites on rat. Ectoparasite means they can infect rats also and humans also. So now when the rat dies, rat fleas may attack man also. And then they transmit plague. How we can control the rats? So in the market there are so many medicines are coming or rat killer and all. So we can use it. We can use the trap also for killing rats, for trapping the rats. So mat pots are coming. We can use. Okay. Now in this chapter. Waterborne diseases we will do in the next video. Okay, so next video I will discuss few question answers and we will complete this waterborne diseases and what are the different types of diseases. Thank you and have a nice day. Please read the chapter as well.